In this tutorial, we'll create a complete animation in After Effects by combining Pastiche, Newton, and a custom expression to visually link all the elements together. We start by creating a vertical composition. I paste the sentence I want to use, and I want to separate each word so they can be animated individually. You can do this manually, but here I use a script called Decompose Text. I select the approximate position option and click Decompose. The result? Each word is placed on a separate text layer. I center each anchor point on its content, center the layers in the composition, fit the layers to comp width, and trim their duration to 30 frames. I then use the proportional grid to position the layers when they appear. Using the keyframe assistant, I apply sequence layers so that the words appear one after another. This animation will serve as the source for Pastiche. I add a solid that will serve as an introduction, also lasting 30 frames. It will appear at the beginning of the comp, before the words. I shift all text layers to start right after this solid. I rename the composition Source. In a new composition, I start by creating a new solid layer of 50 by 50 pixels and apply a circular mask by double-clicking the ellipse tool. This will be my raw material for Pastiche. Duplicate this circle 500 times. You can do it manually or use our MOBA Utils Duplicate Multiple Times to do this faster. I place the source comp above the circles and apply the Pastiche plugin to my source layer. If I click Create directly, Pastiche generates a first collage scattering all 500 circles across the solid. I undo that to return to my initial state. In the settings, I now choose in frames to render every X frames within the work area and enter 30, so collages are generated every 30 frames. I make sure the work area covers all stages of the text animation, extending 30 frames past the last word. Once everything is ready, I hit Create. Pastiche adds keyframes at each text transition and arranges the circles according to the source. I undo once again. Now, I don't want Pastiche to scale the circles. I want them to remain at a fixed size. I check the Ignore Scale option. I test a first version and find the circles are too large relative to the typography. I undo again. Reduce their scale to 50%. To 25%, and relaunch Pastiche. That works much better. The circles are thinner, more spread out, and easier to read. I undo again. I want the starting layout to be a grid and then become more organic as soon as the first word appears. I configure Pastiche's position settings, grid at the beginning, organic after, and then loop the final state back to the initial values so the circles return to their original places. Perfect. I notice there are 9 missing circles in the grid. I undo again, duplicate 9 circles to fill the gaps. Hit Create again, and now the grid is complete. Next, I fine-tune the temporal interpolation to smooth the motion between collages. I select Custom under the temporal interpolation settings, then input 75 for in and 25 for out. This adds easing. The objects start faster and slow down smoothly. Transitions are smoother and feel more breathable. To avoid all the circles moving at once, I set an offset frames value of 6 in Pastiche. This staggers the animation starts by 6 frames. Then I choose different offset methods, depending on the direction I want. For example, random gives a chaotic appearance. Bottom to top animates from bottom upward. I enable animate offset method, so these modes can vary over time. Each text transition now has a distinct movement logic, which makes the overall animation richer and more dynamic. Once I'm happy with the pastiche animation, everything is in place and flows well, I no longer need the source. I delete it and rename this composition so I can clearly identify it as the final pastiche version before continuing with Newton. Now we move on to Newton. I launch Newton from the pastiche composition. If I make a preview, the objects fall due to gravity. So the first step is to disable gravity in the global settings. I also set substeps to 10 for better precision. Then I set all the circles to AEmatic objects. This type of object behaves as if tethered to its original position by an invisible leash. It can move, but it always pulls back toward its origin. This preview was the initial spark for creating this effect inside After Effects. To refine the movement, I adjust two key parameters, damping and tension. I try damping at 1, but that doesn't work. I lower it to 0.6, and now the circles slow down and bounce just the right amount. Another important step, I don't want circles colliding with each other. So I remove them from collision group A by disabling collide with A in the body settings. Perfect. The simulation lasts for 300 frames. Once it's rendered, I return to After Effects and find a new composition named like the original with the suffix unsim01. I create a new composition where I stack the Newton version on top of the pastiche version. To make them easier to distinguish, I apply a fill effect to one of the two so each set has a different color. This lets me see clearly how the two animations diverge. Now I want to draw lines between each circle in the pastiche version and its Newton counterpart. To do that, I use an expression I previously introduced in another tutorial. It creates a path between objects in two compositions based on their index. Let's create a new composition. I create a shape layer, draw a line with two vertices, and apply a 5-pixel stroke. In the path property, I paste the expression. I make sure to update the comp names in the expression so they match my current project. Once the first line is created, I want to duplicate it for every pair of layers. To keep all visual properties linked, I use copy with property links from the original shape layer and paste. Since the expression and path gets overwritten by the paste, I manually reapply it from the original. Now I have two connected lines. I continue duplicating the shape layer until I have 509 lines, one for each pair of circles. There we go. Actually, I realize I have 510 layers, so I duplicate one last time. I rename the composition. Even the preview looks impressive. To enhance the visual style, I tweak the taper settings in the stroke. By reducing the end length, I give the lines a pointed tip, like arrows. It's a small touch, but it adds a lot of personality. I insert this intermediate composition into a final comp, placing it between the source and simulation layers. The result is very clear. You can see how each object is connected to its animated counterpart. Let's hide the objects from the Newton simulation. Finally, to polish the whole look, I add an adjustment layer and apply Deep Glow. If you don't have this plugin, the native glow in After Effects can also work, though it's less intense. And that's the final result. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions or feedback, feel free to reach out. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.